The truth of the matter is that the time has gone and has really gone. Amen. So we are going to make it very, very, very short. Amen. So that we can be on our way as programmed and as planned. Now, but what I want to, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to compress everything I want to say. So if I can just have our attention for a few minutes, then we'll take it from there. Let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name, we give you praise for so far you have helped us. Holy Spirit, we invite you again that you will teach us in Jesus' name. We are in a session of learning practical things that can enhance our ministry, that can make us sharper as instruments in your hands. Lord, we ask you, the teacher, you are recommended by Jesus, that you're going to take his place even when he was not here, and you're going to be always with us. We ask in the name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, teach us in Jesus' name. Amen. And let your hand be upon us, Amen. Upon this association. Amen. Thank you, Father. Thank you, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Praise the living Jesus. Okay, so now let's work with time. It's about 27 minutes or 26 minutes to 11. Amen. And I said by 11, we must be in that van if we really want to make a movie. Praise the Lord. So that leaves us with like 15 minutes or 20 minutes maximum so that we can. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to call it tips. Praise the Lord. So actually today, like I promised yesterday, you know, in the evening was a sermon, was an impartation, was prayer. But this morning, it's just practical things. So I'm just going to narrow down on a foundation that we all know. Luke 14 says, who is that man that intends to build a tower that will not first count the cost? Lest that is in the middle and didn't finish, and all that sees, what would they do? They will laugh at him. The first thing I saw in that scripture is that what God wants you to build is a tower. Praise the Lord. He doesn't want you to build small. He doesn't want you to look for something average. So your intention from beginning must be what? A tower. But building the tower, you must count the cost. So I will say for any production, whether stage play, whether movie, whatever, your foundation is your script. Praise the Lord. And that's what we're going to talk about. Any tower you want to build, in cinema, you want to show it for your congregation or for only your family members, whichever one you are doing, it must be from that foundation of scripture. So I will just say tips to receiving anointed drama messages. Praise the Lord. Amen. Tips to do what? To receiving anointed drama messages. Now, for some of us, you may think, oh, I don't need these, or I'm skilled, or I have so many, I have experiences. But like we said last night in our discussion, if we must make impact in the lives of people, we can't approach this thing from the physical. We need the spiritual angle to it. Just like our Father in the Lord said. He said, all of these visions, you can't do it except by what? The empowerment of the Holy Spirit. And that's what we have seen in his life. It's not like maybe smarter than other people or had degrees. Go and ask him how many degrees does he have. Or, you understand? You can see the power of the Holy Spirit. That's why we call it tips to receiving anointed. And I pray that for all of us, even right before you stand up from this few minutes discussion, something will drop in your spirit. Only three people said that. Amen. Amen. Okay, I pray it for myself before I leave this place. A message that will reach the whole world will drop into my heart. In the mighty name of Jesus. Don't forget where we read yesterday. I started reading 1 Corinthians, if you remember. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, we dwell on verse 4. But if you read down what the Bible says, he said those things. He said, how be it that we speak this wisdom amidst those who are prophets? He said, not the wisdom of this world. Then he went ahead. He said, this wisdom is revealed by his spirit. Then you go to verse 9. He said, eyes have not seen. Ears have not heard. It's not come to the heart of men. What God we do. So what I'm saying is that a script, a storyline, an angle that eyes have never seen, that ears have never heard, that has never crossed anybody's mind, will cross your mind. Amen. Have you watched something like that before? It's so interesting. And you say, wow, you know, you can call it a thriller if you like. You know, you are thrilled, you know, thriller. What eyes have not seen? What surprised people? Or what a suspense that you didn't plan for? And you say, wow, see how the thing came out. I didn't think of that. is something eyes have not seen. It's something ears have not heard. And that's what we are believing God that He will do for us in Jesus' name. All right, what did I call the title of our few minutes discussion? All right, tips. Now, number one. I want to realize that God is the holy source of all divinely anointed drama messages. Please preach it to your neighbor. See, realize that God is the only source of all anointed drama messages. Praise the Lord. You know, we just said that simply. Right? You think, oh, well, I'm a giant in the spirit. I don't even need you to remind me. But the truth of the matter is that many times we need to remind ourselves. Sometimes we think our source can come from somewhere else. We think, oh, let me sit down and watch Netflix very well. By the time I watch like 10 movies, I'll come across something. Yes, you may come across something. But see, God could use a movie on Netflix. God could use, you know, we have had at the mic several times that there are movies He watched that inspire Him to write things. Praise the Lord. So God can use anything, but always realize that who is the source? It is only God. When you do that, then you are going to be able to focus on Him. Praise the Lord. James 1:7-8, if you write the scripture for that, he said, for let not that man think that he will receive anything from the Lord. A double-minded is unstable in all his way. If you know, and if you read verse 5 for that James 1, he said, he that lack wisdom, let him ask of God, who give liberally to all men. He doesn't waver, and he will give it to you. Praise the Lord. So realize that your source is not a book. Your source is not even a tract. You know, it may look spiritual. You say, oh, why, it was a tract of our church. You understand? You realize that even if a message you come from there, it was God that bring it. That's where you will give glory to Him at the end of the day. Praise the Lord. We can say it again. We can't hammer it too much. One of the movies that brought Mount Zion out in those days, many of us heard about the movie, that the man says over and over again. He said he wrote the script to a point and he stopped. He was stuck. He couldn't go ahead again to write again, as he didn't know what next to happen to the man. For 2 days, he was still there in a place praying, and the Holy Spirit asked him that, are you going to give me the glory for this movie? That he had to, that if you look at the raw script, you still see it, and he wrote it on top, that all the glory to you for this movie is you. Do you understand? He wrote it, he bargained with God, it was a covenant. He said after the revelation started flowing, and at that point was when the issue of, if you watch the movie, there was one person that had a spot on top of it, and that thing came. He didn't know how to proceed. He just started the abalist, this. He didn't know which dimension it was going to go. That way, if you realize that God is your source, at the end of the day, you will give Him the glory. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
All right, so it's not a book, it's not a tract, it's not a message, it's not even an experience that is your source. It is who? It is God. However, let somebody say however. He may use a book. He may use a message. He may even use an argument with your wife. Praise the Lord. He may use a message you are listening to. He may use a delay that you are facing. For anything you can use. In fact, that way you open your heart, you open your eyes to the Lord. That Father, you can use anything, but you realize who is the source? God. It is God. I pray the God that you are looking up to, He will deposit something in your spirit. All right, those are the tips. That's number one. Number two of receiving anointed messages is live a life of holiness. What did I say? It may look as if we are saying it again and again, or it's such a trivial matter. No! The reason why I'm saying that is this. Listen, Mark 7:27, the Bible says, He was saying, telling to the Syrophoenician woman, if you remember, He said, let the children be filled first. He said, it's not good to give the children's bread to who? To dogs. So now, I'm the father. I want to give an anointed message. And I see somebody living holy, somebody not living holy. Who do you think I want to give first? Are you following me? So, don't allow anything. We read the scripture yesterday, Mark 2:22. He said, new wine must be poured into new wineskin. He said, you don't put new wine into old wineskin. You pour new wine into old bottle, he said, the bottle will break. It will waste. And God is not a waster. So, make sure our life is a holy life. He's a principal master And he knows that he doesn't want to give the bread to the dogs. I pray in the name of Jesus, as you stay before the Lord, as you purify yourself, God will deposit something strong in your spirit in Jesus' name. I want you to agree with your neighbor in the spirit, say, as you purify yourself. And as you focus on him, what eyes have not seen, a story that he has never heard, a story that never crossed the mind of anybody, we come into your spirit in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. All right, those are the tips. Number one, what's number one? Number two. All right, number three, what I'm going to say is that you should pay attention to the peculiar way that God speaks to you. Now, we are talking about scripting now. And see, you know, scripting can be an art. If you go to Nollywood, go to Hollywood, there are people that are paid for this. They will sit down at their desk and craft something very skillful for you, but it may not touch the lives of anybody. So, that's why I call it anointed message. It's a message. A message means a master sends you a message, and you are the messenger. So that means there's something God wants to communicate and he speaks to you. So you realize, how does he, pay attention to how does he speak to you concerning your life, concerning your finances, concerning your marriage, concerning issues. So realize. So when you pay attention to that, when it's time, maybe you are fasting, you are praying, or you are looking, okay, a drama administration is coming. Oh, they've invited somewhere. They gave us a team. The team is fire, fall down, whatever the team is. And you are looking up to God. And you are praying. He's not going to speak in a different way from how you have been used to. Praise the Lord. That's why, you know, I said tips. Nobody will teach you how. I won't say how, because my how may be different from your how. Are you with us? Praise the Lord. I hope the coffee or the tea is not setting in yet. Is it coffee or tea? I don't know what was it. It's all chocolate. Jesus. Praise the Lord. I thought it was coffee. Praise the Lord. So, make sure it doesn't kick in now. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So pay attention to that, so that the anointing of the Lord can come upon you. Through that same means, God will pass the message across to you. Amen.
Amen.
There are some of us, there are a lot of messages you receive when you sit down and you are listening to a sermon. The pastor may be preaching something, love your wife, love your wife, love your wife. They are preaching about marriage, but you are sitting down and you are getting a different message entirely. There are people like that. Some is just when you are studying your scripture. Some is just when you are praying. Some is some Christians are just discussing. Whichever way, pay attention to that. And the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Okay, number four, because of our time. Exodus 34, verse number 1. Let me just read this to you. And the Lord said to Moses, hew two tables of stone like the first, and I will write upon this table the word that were in the first table which thou breakest. You remember, he collected one, he broke it, and the Lord said he should prepare a plain table. Number four point I want to say, which is very important. If you really want to receive an anointed drama message, clear your mind of every preconceived ideas. Pay attention to this. This is very important. What did I say? Say, clear your mind from every preconceived ideas. Now, there may be something, I'm not talking about maybe a passion. You know, there's a way something may be ringing, maybe about forgiveness, forgiveness, forgiveness. No, that's not what we're talking about, you know. But maybe you saw an issue. Your mother-in-law plus your somebody, they didn't forgive themselves. And that one you want to translate into a script. That's not an anointed drama message. Even though God is speaking to you about forgiveness, forgiveness, but you now went to bring the issue of, you know, what your mother-in-law did and something, something. Why are you ministering to, for God's sake? Hallelujah. So remove that. A few days ago, I slept and I had a dream. You know, I woke up and laughed about myself. I had a dream. I woke up and I began to analyze. You know, recently they had this, there was all over the news, this pastor of Koza and all of that, you know, all over. And I just slept, and I dreamt I was beside the pastor of Koza, and he held his iPad. I said, "Sir, let me look at your iPad." He said, "Why did you want to look at my iPad?" And I was scrolling, and I woke up. I said, "From where?" And I saw that I have been bombarded through Instagram, through Facebook, through TV. So even if I don't want to, in my life I've never met him. So why would I not dream about him? So the first thing coming to me is not as if the Holy Spirit is saying, "Go and do this," or "Go and do this," or "Go and meet him." I know that it was in the multitude of the business that dream was coming from. So, if you are not careful, you want to receive another drama messages. Dr. Nui has stepped on your feet and he didn't say sorry somewhere. And you may import it into something. Or maybe it's the president that, you know, like today, now he gave me a t-shirt. It was too large, but he changed it for me. And I want to bring it to drama. So, you clear your mind. When you clear, the Lord told Moses, he said, "If you are ready to receive this message, go and in a table, make it plain. And I will do what? I will write." Tell your neighbor, say, "Make your heart plain.
Make your heart plain.
So that the Lord can write." Say it one more time. Say, "Make your heart plain. So that the Lord can write." So those are the tips. And I will add this again. Number what now? Number five. Don't delay in jotting down pieces of messages. What did I say? Please say it one more time.
Don't delay in jotting down pieces of messages.
Hallelujah. See, it's only on rare occasion. This, in my own lifetime in drama ministry, in all that I've done, I think it was only once. And that once was because it was a covenant between me and God. I was striking a major covenant with him. And I think as a compensation God gave me, you know. It was only once that I can't forget. I still remember vividly. This happened in Ewe, in Nigeria. I was in a room and I knelt down on beside the bed. And from beginning to the end, the whole drama message, from beginning, what will happen from the beginning of that movie to the end. And it was a movie we had several years ago called One Day to Die, and it blessed the lives of many, many people. Aside that, every other one, maybe today as you're praying, or you sit down, or you get to a point, you have to pray again, or you may even have just the skeleton, you know, but not all the details, so it's so rare. So don't delay. What did I say? Don't delay. So as we are sitting down now, some of you maybe you may start receiving messages. It may just be the beginning. Some it may just be the ending, the resolution, what will happen eventually. Some it just is the confrontation in the middle that you are receiving right now. Some is just the introduction. So no matter how it is, as simple as it is, what do you do? Jot it down. Will you get back to the place of prayer and the Lord begin to help you and everything will come together as it goes. Praise the Lord. Is the Lord helping us today?
Yeah.
Is the Lord helping us today? Yeah. So he may start with the end of the message. He may give you a small bit here and don't assume that you will remember. Yeah. Praise the Lord. Don't assume that you will remember. So the bits and pieces, jot it down. You know they say a short pencil is better than what? A long memory. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Okay, well, let me, that's number five, right? Let's do number six, then we'll round up and we'll begin to go. I've said that you should clear your mind preconceived ideas. But I'm going to say it again in another form, which is number six. Don't adjust messages that God has given you intentionally. You know, it's a different thing that your mind, you had something preconceived that made you to receive a message. But God can even give you a message and you now adjust that message intentionally to attack people. Okay, the word attack may sound kind of. Some, you may say, "Oh, I want to correct our pastor." You know, I don't call it attack now. So it looks spiritual. Those women in church, the things they are doing, they must learn from this movie. Meanwhile, God gave you something and you begin to adjust it. You don't know that every message God gives you. Sometimes it may not make sense to you, but it's the story of somebody somewhere. Somebody somewhere. I've met somebody. One day we were having a movie ministration in Kigali, Rwanda. Kigali. I was there for about 1 week for a ministration. A movie that we did that I did not know. I remember about 1,000 people were in the hall. You know, those people are hungry for God, you know. Film show and the hall, the whole lot, all is filled. After we finished, a lady came and moved and said, in fact, somebody was interpreting what she was saying. She was using their local language called Kirundi to something like that to speak. And she said, Pastor, how did you know the story of my life? And she narrated how exact. Those things that we thought, oh, it may be a bit of exaggeration. That we thought that, can this happen? She said, this is my life exactly. And you came all the way from Nigeria and you told me the story of my life. So don't adjust, don't try to change. If you know God is speaking to you, once it's a godly message, once you know this is according to the will of God, it's according to scripture, don't adjust it. Don't try to alter it. You know, altering it may not only be like in the negative. You may also think you are altering it positively, that thinking, oh, what will people say? This is too... Do you understand what I'm saying? Don't alter it. Be bold. If you need to communicate the message God has given to you, be bold. Let somebody say, be bold. So don't alter it. Hallelujah. All right. And I will give the last one. Be humble. What did I say? Be humble. Be humble. Be humble. That humility, I'm going to explain it. Quickly. That humility. Be humble to receive that message from the Lord. Number one, the Bible says, no man can receive anything except it's given from heaven. John 3:27. You know that. Praise the Lord. So, and it's only an humble heart that God will communicate to. That's part A of humility. Part B of humility is that be humble about the message God has given to you. Be humble enough to give well-experienced writers to look through it, to help you to screen it, to help you to say, bro, this part is a Christian movie, and you are saying, the brother will carry the sister on the lap. What do you think? You understand what I'm saying? Be humble. Don't say, oh, this is how I received it. An angel gave me from heaven. Nobody can help me to scrutinize the script. There are some people like that that say, as a director, we have seen many things. That, oh, as a director, let's do this. And he said, no. And that's how the Lord gave it to me. They gave me like that in the dream. Praise the Lord. And they gave you like that. It's not you, only you that you're going to watch it. Please tell your neighbor, say, be humble, my friend. Praise the Lord. So that humility in receiving from God, humility so that other people can look at it, they can judge it with the Spirit of God. Praise the Lord. The other act, or you may even be in the process of movies shooting, and you know, somebody just make a comment or a contribution. You know, like we were in the car yesterday, and somebody was suggesting something about this script. You know, we were yesterday when we were reviewing the script, some people were suggesting, don't put up an attack and say, no, because I wrote it, or it was me that God gave that script. If you do that, God will not give you another message. Hallelujah. Don't forget, you are also a clay, you are a messenger, that the message that is given to you may have, you know, one or two things, and God will use other people to correct you. Is the Lord helping all of us today? Yeah. So we pray that in the name of Jesus, we will receive anointed drama message. Hallelujah. Yeah. So what's number one we discussed? Number two. Number three. Number four. Please don't delay. Don't delay in even jotting this lecture, okay? Number five. Number seven. Number seven. Be humble. Hallelujah. Amen. So those seven. This is the seventh month. So don't forget all those seven. The Lord will help us in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So before we pray, any question?
Yes.
27th of the 7th. Okay, 27th of the 7th. Yes, sir.
Yeah, I just want to ask, in the area of being
Yes.
How do we balance this? So because there have been times so that you give a message and the director that is coming now, the suggestion you really see that it's really taking the message away.
It's altering the direction of the message entirely. Yeah. Okay, who wants to help us to answer that quickly? Quickly. Okay, yes, sir.
Don't choose a director that is not spirit filled.
Okay, that's one answer. Any other answer? Yes.
If it's truly God's message, God is going to find a way to direct it or align it.
Okay, yes.
Yeah, the director might be spirit filled, but you know, the way we see things at times might be a bit different. So when you see that the director is like taking the message away, you can say, please, can we involve like two other person that is experienced to just help us to make a balance of this so that we verify it? So
okay. Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Yes, sir.
That's why we have a script conference.
Yeah. Before the production.
The director has to be there. Mm-hmm. He has to agree to it. And it's not on set that he'll be doing that. It's when we do our rush thing, we get on
that set. That
the
happens.
Director will say, I didn't even see this script before. And you're coming to direct the movie. Mm. You didn't see the script before. Mm. It's on set that you're changing it. I'm so sorry. That's why I don't read my scripts. Mm. I don't study my lines. Mm. As I speak to you, I don't study. It's when I get there, when the director now says, you want to shoot this scene, I'll pick the script. We'll do it now. Mm. Because I've had experiences in the past where the director will say, I'm so sorry, it was because I didn't read the script. We're going to change these lines after I've prepared. Mm. It can be very...
So... You know, this is the question you brought, very valid question and very important. Just because of time, we have to just round up. We have overshot our time already. So, the preparing is very important. While you are even preparing, some of those things you even didn't get well. You didn't get, you can write the script and some hints are not, you know, because you are not, even if an angel gives you the script, you are not ministering to angel, to human being. They're going to rationalize it. They're going to think it out. So, that's having a pre-production meeting, whether WhatsApp, whether Skype, whether physically, just have it so that everybody, they are on the same page. Because sometimes when we write the script, the writer itself may not, him or herself may not communicate clearly. What is in your heart that you know what you are trying to say, but the way you say it, so the director thought you are saying something else, and they brought out something else. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. You know, it's like what you were saying the other day. That you received it from the Lord.
Yes.
When you had a dream.
Yes.
One girl was singing. Uh-huh. And is that song, that particular song you wanted?
That you want. There are script writers that have, as a director that have found that they may be emotionally connected to a message. And you are right. Some is a song. That song must just be there. And I counsel directors too, that even me myself, I find a way, the best possible way to still incorporate what they want. You understand? Because you don't know. My wife wrote a script at the time. Many of us may have. When she said that song, that in fact, that's the song is the first thing I had in the whole movie. Before the whole movie came. And then I was saying this song. She said that song. You know? So we have to find a way, you know? And there are other people. This woman is worrying. You remember some of the movie that we did, you know? And she said that song. In fact, the first picture I saw is that woman holding her husband by the neck, you know, and they have to fight in that movie. So now, as a director, you can be very creative, because it's also the pleasure of the writer to see the things that they receive come to life. But both of you will strike a balance, meet in the middle.
Because I was there when you were arguing.
Maybe, yes, you are in that movie. See, but eventually, some people, it's not the director or the writer, that will be the people that are watching it. In fact, the people watching it don't have a business with whether you receive or you die. They didn't even know they directed the movie. They just know it's a movie. Like my dad, when my dad watch a movie and he likes it, he say, I want her to play a girl. When she won't act, I want to quit. All right, let's rise up on our feet and pray. Praise the Lord. Father, we thank you, we give you praise. Blessed be your name. Lord, we present ourselves before you again because we know nothing. 1 Corinthians 8:2, we read. He said, we don't know as we ought to know. That's why we present our ignorance again. Father, teach us yourself. Make us stronger, better, sharper instruments in your hand so that we can be effective in our world. Thank you, Father. As we proceed to our destination now, let your presence go with us. Help us in today's production. And let your name be glorified. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.